opportunity to collect rain. I'll show you a little demo, but the way that it works is a rain sensor that counts the raindrops, select how many gallons you want to flush. You've got a valve that stays in the position when it's in a ready state, waiting for the rain. This rain sensor, since it senses any raindrops, it does it by activity, not moisture. Since it's in raindrop activity, you can start counting those raindrops. Set. And that advance will pass through that normally open valve and flush to daylight. A drain field, backyard, down a slope. We usually use pop-up emitters or lateral valves to keep the pests out. So once that water gets drained out and it's at that threshold, that valve closes, and then the water then takes the path of the resistor, which is into the storage tank.
That's our bread and butter. This is one product or two products that we've developed, and our
bread and butter is we design and install and maintain rainwater systems. That's my passion. We'll always do that.
Well, thank you so much, Zach. We learned a lot about this first flush system. One more question. Is the first flush diversion system required in the state of Texas?
It's not required, but strongly suggested. It is in the handbook for the Texas Rainwater Commission. There's a handbook and there's standards that they want you to follow. There are some systems within different districts that if you don't have the different elements to that rainwater system to make sure that it's running efficiently and doing what it's supposed to do, sometimes it won't pass. In our case, we do everything in well above and beyond to make sure that it looks good and it's good quality.
Sounds great. Thank you so much, Zach.
Good.